गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। वेलकम टू द वेबिनार गाइस। सो प्लीज लेट मी नो वेदर माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल और नॉट। शशिपाल, एम आई ऑडिबल? इज द वॉइस क्वालिटी गुड गाइस? गुड टू सी यू गाइस। शशिपाल, स्वर्णलता, आयनिश in almost all the webinars. Good to see you all. So I request my team members to, you know, give me the privileges to share the screen. Thank you. So guys, is the voice quality good? I think I'm sharing my screen, am I? Everything seems to be fine, right? So there are no issues. Fantastic. So can I just get a minute, please? We will start in a minute, guys. Sure. Just a minute. So guys, my name is Arvind Reddy Dudipala, and I will be the host or instructor for today's webinar. I hope you all had a great day. So guys, how was your day so far? I hope it has been good. So probably guys, there might be a slight background noise, so wherein you guys have to, you know, excuse me for that. Sure. Is that okay? Guys, if you all are ready, then I'm ready to start the webinar. So how many of you are ready? I hope you all had a great day, and I request everyone to please choose all panelists and attendees option. Guys, while sending the messages, you have multiple options which you can choose from the drop-down menu. So I request everyone to choose all panelists and attendees option. Majority of you have chosen just all panelists option. So the advantage is when you are asking a question, the other participants will be able to see only when you choose all panelists and attendees option. Otherwise, if you choose only all panelists, I'll be able to see the, you know, queries. So I request everyone to please choose that option, right? So before we get into the webinar, guys, of course, I'll talk about myself and, you know, all of that would definitely happen. So just to begin with, I'm telling you my name once again. My complete name is Arvind Reddy Dudipala, and I'll be the instructor for today's webinar. So this time, I just wanted to understand the background of the participants that I have in the session. So I have a small query kind of thing. So I request everyone to, guys, I request everyone to please give me some information about you, such as I want your complete name along with your education qualification and your current designation and the company where you are working. If you can mention number of years of experience, that would be great. All of this, please try to send in a single message. Don't send it in multiple messages. All of the information, just type it in two or three lines and send it across in a single message. So how many of you are willing to do that? So that way, I just wanted to understand what kind of participants do I have in the webinar today. So are you ready? I'm repeating it again. So your name followed by the education qualification, followed by the designation, number of years of experience, and the current company in which you are working. Shashipal from Indore, student MBA in BA second, okay, second semester, okay? Great, so you did, okay. Lakhan Singh, it would be great if you can send out the complete information in terms of what are you doing and all of that. How Mohammed Adnan Wajid sent, BTech site lead, O&M 8 years, Inspire Clean Energy Private Limited. We have Deep Mala pursuing PhD Computer Sciences and Engineering. That's good to know, Deepa. And we have Nitin Kshir Sagar. We have Atul Gupta from Noida. And we have Ayanesh Banerjee. You're a student, 0 years of experience and no technologies that you're aware of. Fantastic, no problem. Then Ravi from Delhi, Ravi Ranjan, and we have Vidris Giwala Vika, marketing professional with 11 years of experience. Very good, looking for the opportunities. Subodh Singh, final year undergraduate. Okay, ML intern at Samsung India. That's fantastic, Subodh. And we have Rose Ash, and we have Gurinder Kaur from Punjab, student BTech in computer sciences and technology. That's very good to know, guys. I'm really happy to know your background and all of that stuff. Thank you so much about it, and thanks for giving the brief information about it. So that I just wanted to make my own plan key, from where I have to start the webinar. So Nitin Kshir Sagar, you are from VEEP background, self-employed, trade in solar meter. We have Abuzar. Thank you so much, guys. So I don't want to waste any more of your time. So before we get into the webinar, I have a very simple question. And guys, if you can, respond to my queries, then only I'll be able to make the session as interactive as possible. Are you getting my point, guys? If we have to make the session very interactive, definitely I just wanted to get the responses from each and everybody. So how many of you would really want to respond to my queries? Because if I keep on taking you guys through the slides or code kind of thing, that looks very monotonous. Maybe after 10 or 15 minutes, you don't feel like continuing. So for that reason, can I request each and everybody to respond to the queries that I'm going to ask? Okay. My very first query, before we get started, is how many of you are aware of the topic for today's webinar? I mean to say, I'm not asking you guys the in-depth knowledge of it. I'm just asking you, how many of you are at least aware of the topic? I mean to say, what are we going to discuss in today's webinar? Guys, can I please get the responses? How many of you are at least aware of the topic for today's webinar? Of course, you might see that on the screen, but still, guys, what are you going to learn in today's webinar? Okay, some people know, some people does not know. Majority of the people are saying this is into NLP, this is into machine learning, language translator. So I'm not really asking about the technology that we use kind of thing, guys. If you guys are talking to me about the technology, I'm more than happy. But the very first thing, which I wanted to mention here is the topic for today's webinar is nothing but it's a language translator using machine learning. So first of all, you need to understand what is machine learning and what is the necessity to go with something called as a language translator and all those things. So can we talk a little bit about the background and then we jump into the topic? What do you say, guys? Always I have this habit of taking the session this way, guys. First, I wanted to give you the introduction to the technology that you're going to learn today. If you understand the applications of it, then we can jump into the topic. Otherwise, if I directly start with the topic, then that does not help you much. Okay. So I know there are some people who have been attending my sessions, more than once or twice they have attended. For those people, it might sound repetitive in the beginning, but I just wanted to keep everybody in my mind and I wanted to do it that way. Sure. So before we get into the topic, guys, I have some, very basic questions to everybody, because the intention behind these particular sessions is nothing but we just want to bring in some awareness among the people in terms of what is artificial intelligence and what are the applications of it and all of that. So the first few minutes, maybe 5-10 minutes, we have to spend on what is AI and what are its applications kind of thing. So guys, how many of you have an answer to this question? What is artificial intelligence? All of you, if someone knows or someone does not know, it's okay. But you guys respond whether you have ever heard about this terminology, which is called as AI or which is something called as artificial intelligence. How many of you are there, guys? How many of you are familiar with this particular topic? Ramadas says they are familiar with it. Arjuman and and also I think Nitin Kshir Sagar are somebody, Galaxy J7 Prime, they are saying that they have got some idea about it. So Krishna Kumar, according to you, AI is just the chatbots, or is it just a part of AI? Is chatbots a part of AI? So let's try to understand this in as much detail as possible. Okay, guys, how many of you are up for it? Actually, I just wanted to make you guys familiar with the topic AI. Then I can take you guys through this particular topic. So I have got some responses. Mr. Shashipal says that simulation of human intelligence, that's a very perfect answer. And Nitin says, like, you know, human intelligence by machines. Okay. You mean to say you are impacting some sort of like, you know, intelligence to the machines. Okay. And Deepmala says, like, you know, it's like automation. Automation is just a part of it, Deep. And object with intelligence kind of thing, Krishna Kumar says that. You know, that's all fantastic, guys. Like, you know, let me ask you a question before we get into this. What is intelligence, guys? Like, you know, I mean to say, isn't intelligence a natural, you know, trait that everybody has? What do you say, guys? Don't you think that intelligence comes naturally to each and every individual? But in this case, we are trying to say that, like, you know, artificial intelligence. So what does that mean? Like, you know, are we going to create any sort of... Just a minute, guys. Hey, guys. Sorry, there was some background noise, so I had to... you know, rectify that. So I'm just talking about this, guys. You know, intelligence is something natural. When I say artificial intelligence, we are trying to make the machines intelligent. So if I say this, actually, what is the necessity to make the machines intelligent? Can someone tell me? Why should we world changing the technology? We need to train them and, like, you know, all of that is there. Okay. So let me just take a very simple example, guys. We all have this, you know, smartphones with us, right? Let me take some layman's example, like, you know, which you guys are familiar with. You have smartphone, and in your smartphone, actually, what are the different unlocking systems that you have? Guys, how many unlocking systems do you have in your phone? You can just do that through the pattern. You can just do that through, like, you know, some sort of, like, you know, pattern, the password, and also some sort of, like, you know, fingerprint. And finally, you also have something called as face detection. What do you say, guys? You also have an application which says that, like, you know, you have something called as face detection. So let's try to understand a little bit about, like, you know, this face detection. Okay. What is the objective behind using this face detection? All of you, please respond. First of all, what is the objective? See, when you are doing certain tasks, there is an objective, right? Like, you know, why do you have to do that? So when you are using this face detection or, like, you know, face recognition kind of thing, what is the objective? Here, you just wanted to unlock your phone. What do you say, guys? You just wanted to unlock your phone that you don't want to do manually, but in wherein, you know, a security is the object. That's a perfect answer, Krishna. So in this case, you know, security is the object, you know, objective that you have. But in addition to that, like, you know, you also have something like, you know, you just wanted to unlock your phone. In order to unlock the phone, you have multiple ways of doing it. So one such thing is nothing but face detection. So if any one of you, you know, unlock with high security kind of thing. So if you remember, guys, when you purchase the phone for the, you know, first time, and when you are trying to set up, like, you know, this unlocking system with the face recognition, did the phone not ask you to take the images in multiple directions? What do you say, guys? Are you with me? For the first time, when you are trying to set up this face detection thing, it will try to capture, like, you know, as many images as possible. So why is it doing so? Can someone answer this question? I mean, it will try to take your images in as many directions as possible. And also one more thing that it does there is, like, you know, it will, nowadays it is also asking you to wear the specs. Like, you know, for example, in future, even if you're wearing the spectacles, it will be able to, you know, recognize you. So that is also happening. So in this case, the machine is nothing but your mobile phone is asking you to give some data in the form of images. Guys, are you understanding? So our face look changes with mood, outdoor travels and all of that. So that's the reason, like, you know, it will try to take the images in multiple directions. So why is it even asking for the images is my question, guys. Can someone answer this? Because it just want to learn something from the images. It just want to learn something from the images. So I have a very simple question, which I keep on asking in, like, you know, all my webinars. So guys, let's assume that, like, you know, you are leading a team or, like, you know, you are the team manager or something. Okay. And you have to take a decision. So your decision depends on what? What influences your decision? When can you take the proper decision? Please tell me. Guys, you are stuck in a situation and you have to take a decision. So when can you take a proper decision is my question. Only when you have experienced that in the past. If not the exact thing, like, you know, if you have experienced, like, you know, some sort of similar situation in the past, then you'll be able to face that situation and you'll be able to take a decision, right? So in a similar way, when you are using the machines for the decision making, if the machines have to learn something and, like, you know, if they have to become intelligent, definitely they have to go through some instances, right? So those instances are nothing but, like, you know, we call them as data. I mean to say, you have to input, or, like, you know, you have to feed some data to the machine. You have to feed some data to the machine so that the machines become, like, you know, they learn something from the data that you have given, then they become intelligent. So everywhere, like, you know, to the machines, you have to provide some sort of, like, you know, what do you call data, then only they'll be able to become intelligent. So here, guys, just to make the things, like, you know, little more clear and all. So can I give you some basic example? What is data science? Like, you know, what is artificial intelligence and all of that? Can I just give you one simple example so that you'll be able to understand it in a better way? How many of you are up for it, guys? I understand. We will definitely move on to today's topic. But before that, I just wanted to give you the basics so that you all will understand. Okay. Now you help me understand this question, guys. I have certain numbers, like, you know, 3, 6, 9, comma 12, because there might be some set of people who are really interested in math, right? So 3, 6, 9, 12. So what is the next number? What are the next two numbers that I'm getting here, guys? Can someone tell me? If I have 3, 6, 9, and 12, and I'm asking you guys to predict the next two numbers. So what are those two numbers? I think it's a pretty simple question. Almost everybody is going to answer. So who is answering this question? Why is only Krishna, Nitin, Atul are answering, Swarnalata? So why not other people? Why not other people? So definitely it's going to be 15, 18, 21, 24 and all of that. So what made you guys think that, like, you know, the answers are 15 and 18? Can someone help me understand it? Guys, why did you even think that, like, you know, the answers are 15 and 18? Because you have identified some set of patterns from the data. So what I'm trying to explain here is, guys, if you consider this thing, all of this data, you can consider it as past data. Do you agree? And you are trying to predict something into the future. Do you agree, guys? So what is it doing? So it is learning something from the past data. And also it is trying to use what it has already learned. And it is going to use that for the future. So in a similar way, in artificial intelligence also, the same thing happens. It will learn something from the past. It will learn something from the past and it will try to predict something into the future so that the humans can take the better decisions. Is it making sense? Guys, if you look at the steps that are involved in this, actually, there is something called as, guys, there is something called as data analysis, which you have done. Do you agree, guys? Whatever the data that is given to you, first of all, you have analyzed it. After analyzing the data, you have discovered the pattern. Do you agree, guys? We have something called as you have discovered a pattern. Now you tell me, in this case, if I'm asking you to predict the next two terms, you did that. But what if I'm asking you to predict the 200th term? Guys, what do you do? Do you write the series till the 200th term? Definitely no, right? There should be a formal way, or, like, you know, there should be a way in which you have to formulate the pattern. Whatever the pattern that you have discovered, you should be in a position to put that in the form of a formula. Do you agree, guys? So whatever the pattern that you have discovered, what you have to do is you have to generalize the pattern. What do you have to do? You have to generalize the pattern. And what is the next step? You have to predict into the future. Guys, are you understanding my steps? So similarly, when it comes to, like, you know, data, AI, machine learning, deep learning, artificial intelligence, like, you know, data science everywhere, these are the steps, like, you know, basically that we do. There are many more steps. So that is, whenever you have the data, you will analyze the data. Then you discover a pattern from that. Then you will try to generalize the pattern. And finally, using the pattern that you have generalized, you will predict something into the future. So guys, is it making sense? So this is what generally, like, you know, what do you call, like, you know, AI is. This is what machine learning is. This is what deep learning is. This is what NLP is. Like, you know, everywhere that the concept is the same, guys. Though you might implement that in, like, you know, but many different ways actually, but everywhere you try to do this only. So in this case, I can say that the nth term is nothing but, like, you know, Tn is equals to 3 times of n. If I want the fifth term, I can plug in n equals to 5. Sixth term, I can plug in n is equals to 6 and all of that. So this is a little bit about, like, you know, artificial intelligence, you know, machine learning, deep learning and all of that. So let me just give you a little more insights into this, guys. We all have access to YouTube, right? You might also have some access to some OTT platforms, like, you know, Netflix, you know, Amazon Prime, or, like, you know, some other things, right? So whenever you try to open that, I mean to say, you have watched something and, like, the next time you are opening, can you see some recommendations over there, guys? Have you ever observed, like, you know, some sort of recommendations over there? definitely it gives you some recommendations, right? I mean, if you have watched some sort of like, you know, thriller movies in the past, or like, you know, horror or romantic movie or comedy movie or anything, the next recommendations are just based on that. So that is called as recommender system, which is an application of AI. I mean, it's a majority of the OTT platforms, like, you know, this YouTube and like, you know, everybody is using that, which is a part of AI. Now, I'm trying to take you guys slowly towards today's topic. How many of you are familiar with something called as Amazon Alexa, or else something called as Apple Siri and all of these things? Guys, have you heard about, like, you know, Amazon Alexa? And you have something called as Apple Siri kind of thing. What are those? Cortana and all these things. Those are nothing but, like, you know, virtual voice assistants, right? Virtual voice assistants. If you are seeking for some information, then they'll be able to give you some information, right? So definitely, those are nothing but those are some applications of AI. To be precise, those are some applications of natural language processing. I mean to say, there we are trying to take the data in the form of the natural language. For example, if your mother tongue is English or Hindi or, like, you know, some other regional language also, still you'll be able to, like, you know, build some application based on that. Are you getting this? So in addition to this, I also have something, guys. Whenever you log into some website, actually, for example, HDFC or Bajaj or for that matter, any website, whatever you consider, as soon as you log into the website, can you see some, like, you know, square, you know, message box kind of thing at the bottom right corner? Guys, have you ever observed that? So that is nothing but, like, you know, we call it as a chatbot. What do you call that? You call it as a chatbot. And, like, you know, that chatbot is nothing but, like, you know, it's an automated one with the help of some technology, which is called as natural language processing. Are you getting my point? So that is made with the help of natural language processing. Do you think a human is sitting there and, like, you know, answering all your questions? No. We have automated all of that with the help of AI. Again, NLP is a part of AI. So slowly, we are moving towards Luis, and, like, you know, there are many other things which can be used over there. As you mentioned, like, you know, Krishna Kumar, like, you know, there are multiple ways so in which that can be done. So in today's session, we are going to learn about some application of NLP, which is nothing but, like, you know, language translator. See, guys, recently, I'll tell you, one of my friends, he's a vlogger. Like, you know, I mean to say, he travels and, like, you know, he posts his videos on YouTube. So he went to Russia recently. Last week, he went to Russia. So in the beginning, he had got some, like, you know, what do you call, like, you know, this language issues and everything. So for everything, like, you know, whatever he wanted to ask, he has used some translator, like, you know, English to Russia. Are you understanding? English to Russian language. So he has used something called as translator. Translator is nothing but, like, you know, the language translator. So that can be developed with the help of something called as natural language processing. So in today's session, we are going to discuss something about this language translator. How can that be, you know, what do you call, built with the help of NLP? Okay. So guys, now I'm moving on to the PPT that I was sharing earlier. So as we were on the whiteboard, so I'm getting here. So guys, are you clear now what is AI? And also, like, you know, what are you going to learn in today's session? Guys, is that clear? Did I give you some basic about AI? Now, are you guys in a little better position to understand the session or not? Please tell me. Information desk, I'm sharing the PPT. I stopped sharing it for a while because I was sharing the whiteboard. Okay, for your information. Sure. Can we move on, guys? Their 200th term, Kartikeya, for example, in the same series, if I ask you guys, like, you know, to find out the fifth term, then you can simply write it. But if I'm asking you guys to find out the 200th term, you have to plug in that into the formula 3N. N is equals to 200. So 2 into 300. So the 200th term, there will be, like, you know, 600. So something like that. So we will generalize the pattern, like, you know, denote that with the help of a formula or function. Then when you have the input, you'll be able to predict the output, Kartikeya. So that is the whole intention. So guys, in today's webinar, you guys are going to learn something about language translator using ML. Here, ML stands for machine learning. Machine learning is nothing but, like, you know, where the machines are going to learn from the data that we are going to give them as inputs. Is it making sense? Now, the next thing is, guys, let's look at my profile. Guys, this is me. I look like this. And this is my complete name, Arvind Reddy Dudipala. You can find me on LinkedIn. If you send me the connection request, I'll just look into that and, like, you know, I'll accept it. Currently, I'm working with Datafox as a principal data scientist, and also on the weekends, I take the, you know, sessions, so senior faculty. And I have got close to 18 years of experience, guys. And within, to, I mean to say, into this particular domain, I have got close to 8 years of experience. And I have majorly worked in the manufacturing industry. I worked in, like, you know, insurance and a bit of banking industry and some other random domains also. I'm familiar with, you know, working on the chatbots and, like, the computer vision and all of that stuff. So this is a little bit about the trainer. I mean to say, who is instructing you for today, because you have that basic right to know about the, you know, trainer, like, you know, who is taking the session for you, right? So this is about me, guys. So now let's move on to the actual thing. So before we get into this session, I request everyone to please follow the basic rules, like, you know, don't spam in the chat window. And the second thing is, like, you know, I request everyone to keep the mobile phones in a silent mode, or, like, you know, you can just switch off them. And the next thing is, if you have any questions, just keep them for the end of the session, for ending of the session, because towards the end of it, like, you know, we are going to discuss some Q&As and all of that. And the fourth one is, like, you know, if you really feel that there are some important points which you can take home, then you can just make a note of those things. Am I making sense? Okay. Now, this is the objective for today's webinar, guys. What are we going to learn? In this webinar, we will see how English can be translated to other languages using machine learning. For example, you have something to convey to somebody, like, you know, who is a French person, or, like, you know, who is a German, or, like, you know, who is a Russian or something. So how can that be done? So in this webinar, we will show you the practicals also, not just the theory. You will also learn the practicals. Okay, first of all, you will learn what are the technologies that have been used for this, and, like, you know, how the coding and, like, you know, that part has been done. So let's move on to that. So how many of you are excited for it, guys? Okay. So first, we just wanted to give you a little introduction to AI, which I have already given. AI makes it possible for machines to learn from experiences, adjust to new inputs, and perform human-like tasks. Like, you know, guys, humans are also the same, right? You know, I mean to say, they're quite adaptive in nature. What do you say, guys? When a new situation comes, they will try to learn something from that. So when it comes to the machines also, they learn in the same way. Most AI examples from, you know, include chess playing computers to self-driving cars, rely heavily on deep learning and natural language processing. And the next thing is, guys, machine learning. Machine learning is nothing but it is a subsidiary. I mean, it's a subpart of, like, you know, AI, which deals with learning certain things from the past data, generalizing them, so that can be used for predicting something into the future. So am I clear with this slide, guys? Okay, so if this is clear, let's move on to the next one. So guys, what are the things that we have basically used in this? One thing is text to blob. I'll give you a brief idea about, like, you know, what is text to blob and what is this translate. And, like, you know, finally, we have used one web application, which is called as Streamlit. Text to blob is nothing but, like, you know, guys, for today's webinar, you know, using a programming language is very important, right? So for that, we have used something called as Python. In Python, you have so many ready-made frameworks, actually. For example, if you wanted to use machine learning, then you have a framework which is called a scikit-learn kind of thing. You also have TensorFlow. You have called, like, you have something called as Matplotlib Seaborn for the visualizations. So in a similar way, just to deal with the text to data and to do the NLP related tasks and everything, you have a package, or, like, you have a library kind of thing, which is called as text to blob. And we use a function which is called as translate. And finally, whatever the code that you have developed and whatever you are trying to do, for everything, the user interface is very, very important, right? So this Streamlit web app will, I mean, it's a Streamlit will help you to create some, like, you know, user interface kind of thing. So let's try to look at that. So guys, have you got some basic idea about this? We are going to make use of three things. One is text to blob. Then you have something called as Translate. You also have something called as Streamlit web application. Okay. Now, the next thing which I'm talking about here is, you know, text to blob. Text to blob is a Python library for processing textual data. I mean to say, whatever the data that you have in the form of text, and offers a simple API to access its methods and perform basic NLP tasks. Are you guys understanding it, guys? I mean to say, when you are running your Python, you just have to call this particular library. You have to import it, or, like, you know, if it is not installed, you have to install, so that establish a connection with it. So, you know, you can perform NLP related tasks over there. So to be precise, you have something called as NLTK, guys, in Python, which is natural language toolkit, which is generally used for the natural language processing to achieve certain tasks. So we are going to make use of text to blob. You guys can do some research about text to blob. That's okay. And the next thing that you have here is, guys, what are functions, guys? usually what are functions in a programming language point of view? Can someone tell me? Functions are nothing but like, you know, there can be user defined functions, there can be like, you know, inbuilt functions. So translate is a function that we have which can perform a task of like, you know, taking the inputs, you know, in any of the languages and like, you know, converting it into another language, whatever it supports. Yes, functions would definitely return some values. That's true, Krishna. So in this case, we are going to use something called as translate. Guys, don't you think function is a block of code? That's perfect. So guys, in this case, the function name itself is quite evident, right? When I say translate, so probably it can be used for translating something from like, you know, one language to another language. What do you say, guys? Do you agree if I say that? So translate function is a part of text blob library and is used to translate one language into another language. So here it accepts two arguments. See guys, when I say function, what are the arguments? The arguments are nothing but like, you know, whatever it takes. So in this case, it takes two arguments. One is like, you know, from language, and the second thing is to. From language mentions like, you know, is it English or like, you know, from which language you want to convert into another language. To, for example, I wanted to convert from English to, you know, French or something. So from language will become English and to will become French. Is it clear, guys? So translate is one simple function. It looks very simple, but like, you know, it has got a lot of functionality within it. Is it making sense? It has got lots of functionality within it. Guys, can we please move on? Okay. And the next thing is nothing but like, you know, Streamlit. Streamlit is nothing but, guys, it's again another open source library that you have in Python. In Python, majorly, we have the open source libraries only, guys. I mean to say, you know, you will have the access to it, like, you know, without paying anything. And also even tomorrow, if you wanted to make some changes to that or like, you know, customize it, you can do that. It is not a closed thing or nothing like that. I mean, it has got a basic syntax kind of thing wherein everybody can, you know, modify it, like, you know, according to their needs. Like, you know, there are so many parameters that can be passed into that and that way. So Streamlit is nothing but an open source Python library that makes it easy to create and share beautiful custom web apps for machine learning and data science projects. Are you understanding? So if you have a very beautiful application to translate this to that thing. So in such cases, what you can do is, just a second, guys. Hey guys, so yeah. So I mean to say, whatever the code that you have, there is a final, you know, ultimate use of it, right? So it will help you to create like, you know, some sort of good web applications and all of that. So that will be shown in today's webinar. Don't worry. Okay. So guys, the languages that we have majorly used in today's session are like, you know, something like, you know, French, Spanish, Russian, Hindi, and all of this. What do you say, guys? Can we please move on? So here is an example. For example, you know, how are you in the sense like, you know, aapka kaise ho? So how is that in like, you know, French and the other languages, Russian? So guys, as I told you, or like, you know, as I promised in the beginning itself, it's not just the theory class. Our team member is going to come and like, you know, they're going to demonstrate some live session to you all. So who is there from our team? Is it Deepanshi or like, yeah, you know, is it Kanish?
Yeah, hi everyone, Deepanshi here from data science team of Data Folks. And today I'll be showing the demo of the webinar. So can you please provide me the access to share my screen?
Definitely, Deepanshi, just give me a moment.
Yeah. Hi everyone, how are you on? Yeah, hi. Okay, so are you ready for the demo? Okay, so is my screen visible to everyone? Great. So like always, I have opened Anaconda prompt here and we'll go to the directory where our code is there. So first of all, I am going into the directory where my code is placed. Yeah, Vijay, I'm doing great. Thanks for asking. So as we have made a Streamlit app, so we will run this code by using Streamlit. Now it will appear in our browser. As you can see, can you guys see my screen now? English translator, English language translator by DataFox. Okay, so first of all, we are going to see the Hindi language. So what should I write here? Let's start with how are you doing? One second. Yeah. So you can see how it has translated the text into Hindi from English to Hindi. By the way, we also have Telugu language here. So can you, do you want to see the Telugu translation of it?
Of course, I'm excited, Deepanshi, because my mother tongue is Telugu.
Oh, great. Okay, so let's translate into Telugu. So how many of you know Telugu here?
See guys, how many of you know Telugu here? I'm a Telugu person, Nak Telugu. So Aditya, so how are you going to Yamanta Manam Telugu? No, well, I'm now under. So let me read out.
Yeah, so you guys tell me what should I write there.
So how are you doing in the sense? What's your age or something like that?
Okay.
I mean to say, have you trained it on all of those things? What is your age you can put? You translate it to Malayalam. It's Malayalam. Translate it to Telugu.
Shubham, we have not included Marathi in it for now.
Okay, no problem, Deepanshi. Okay, so you just do it in like, you know, whatever languages for which you have trained it rigorously. I mean to say Hindi to French or like, you know, some other language. Okay, sure. Deepanshi, do it from Hindi to English, wherein English to Hindi, wherein majority of people can understand Hindi, right? So let's not get too much into the regional languages wherein the people get.
Yeah, sure, sure. Okay, so let's go with Hindi now. Okay, so let me try, I have developed more models into it, so let me try with that now. Okay. You guys suggest what should I write here? I think I have run the wrong file now.
Deepanshi, whatever you have trained on, just run that. It's okay. We just wanted
to actually, by mistake, I ran the wrong file.
Okay.
Okay, so tell me, what should I write here?
Or something like, you know, where is your house or something? What is your age? Huh?
See, in Hindi we have translated into.
Badiya. So, ye puch rahe ki tumhara umr kya hai? That's very good. Aapka naam kya hai bolke puchhiya?
Acha. Do you all vaccinate?
Kya aap sabhi ka theek hai karan? Okay. Chalo, aur ek dal dijiye aap.
Okay.
Anything, whatever you feel comfortable. Ab kar rahe ho. Acha.
Everyone can suggest.
Hey guys, whatever that comes to your mind, like, you know, you guys can tell us one or two so that Deepanshi can show you guys that.
Yeah, I can show you one or two more. So please suggest more.
What's your hometown? Aisa kuch puchhiya?
You can also translate into French. See, but as we do not know French, so we'll not be able to understand.
कनाडा मतलब रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस में वी हैवन ट्रेन्ड मच, कृष्ण कुमार एंड अदर्स, रघुनाथ यू स्टे इन हैदराबाद.
ट्राई व्हाट इज एआई, एआई क्या है, दैट वाज सिंपल.
स्पैनिश मतलब यू नो गाइस, आई टेल यू ओके. So Dipanji, is there anything else that you wanted to demonstrate? Maybe
no. Just I have developed all that in these languages, so we can see French, Russian, okay.
So guys,
Spanish.
See. Yeah, Russian, Spanish, anything. Dipanji, let me know when you are done. I mean, if you have something
sure,
else.
Yeah, sure,
I am
done.
You're done, Dipanji. Okay. So guys. Am I audible? Guys, please let me know if I'm audible or not. Dipanji, am I audible?
Yeah, your voice is broken a little.
It said my internet connection is unstable kind of thing. So that's... Yes, perfect. Okay. See, guys, libraries and packages are nothing but Krishna. So those are kind of, you know, compilation of certain functions. You can call them and, like, you know, you can perform certain tasks. So let's try to look at this, guys. Summary. I mean to say, what have you seen in today's session? Guys, I'll tell you certain things. Okay. Can I request everyone's attention, please? Hey, guys, can I please request everyone's attention? Please. There is something which I wanted to explain. See, the reason behind coming up with this webinar and, like, you know, showing you guys something, you know, in practical is nothing but, like, you know, we just wanted you guys to, you know, have some awareness about, like, you know, what's happening in this industry. And how can these things be possible? Like, you know, earlier, like, you know, there are so many assumptions and everything that, like, you know, only some high level people can do that and all of that stuff. No, nowadays, like, you know, everybody can learn AI and also they can develop all these applications. So that is a whole intent behind it. And we just wanted to bring in some awareness in terms of what's going in the space of, like, you know, artificial intelligence. So how was the demo, guys? Let me just ask you from everybody. How was the demo? Did you all enjoy it? See, Nitin, we are not trying to say that, like, you know, Google is not giving and all that. So we also just wanted to tell you, like, you know, some people are not even aware of that. So we just wanted to bring in some awareness. So every week we are trying to bring in a topic. It's not that, like, you know, we are building, you know, something new or nothing like that. So we just wanted to make the people, you know, aware of all these things. So that is the whole intent. Now you guys tell me one simple question, guys. Okay. Introduction to AI. Good. Yeah. That's the whole intent. Actually, we want, see, you know, Nitin, if you talk about, actually people are even going to the, you know, space and, like, you know, doing all of that. So that does not mean that, like, you know, if SpaceX is doing something or, like, you know, if someone else is doing something, that does not mean that, like, you know, we should not educate the people about it. Right. So we have to educate the people about, like, you know, what's happening in that relevant industry so that some of them can also grab the opportunity in that particular space, right? So that's the reason and the intent behind, like, you know, doing these webinars. It's not that, like, you know, we are doing it for the first time ever or, like, you know, nothing as such. No, we are not claiming it that way. We just wanted to bring in some awareness. So that is the only intention, guys. Don't get us wrong. Nowhere we are trying to projecting it as, like, you know, we have developed it or something like that. We just wanted to compile certain things and definitely we have developed certain things. But in today's webinar, what we are trying to do is already we have existing applications. So how are they functioning actually? So we just wanted to, you know, break it into simple things and, like, you know, showcase it to everybody so that they can understand it. Now you tell me, guys, after looking at this webinar, now majority of people might be very much impressed with it or, like, you know, they might be amazed and all these things. So now you tell me, how many of you wants a career in artificial intelligence? I need an answer to this question, guys. If you really like the demo and, you know, or else if you really like the intention behind the demo, and what's happening in the space of AI, so the domain, right? Probably you just wanted to make a career shift kind of thing. So how is, I mean to say, like, you know, how many of you really wanted to do that? I have got 5-6 responses. Oh, good, good. I'm getting more responses. So there are many people who really wanted to make a career in artificial intelligence, right? Okay. Now let me ask you one thing, guys. You know, if you wanted to prepare for some examination, right? if you wanted to prepare for some examination, definitely you need proper guidance or not. You cannot really go through Google and like, you know, I mean, it's a, the order of the things matters and how organized they are, that also matters, and all of that is there, right? So now I just wanted to take 2 or 3 minutes of my time to explain you guys what is the order in which you guys have to learn AI. I mean, to say, what should be the learning path for that? So can I take a few minutes to explain that? Just in the simplest possible way, I wanted to show it to everybody that, like, you know, how can someone get into the field of AI? If they have to learn AI, where should they start and where should they end, kind of thing. So can I take a few minutes to talk about it, guys? Is that okay? Fantastic. Now, the next thing is, see, guys, thank you so much for your responses. Okay. If you wanted to learn some language, for example, if you wanted to learn Hindi language, where do you start it, guys? You start it with Varnamala. Then you will move on to Barakhadi. Then you started exploring the sentences and all of that. Similarly, if somebody wants to learn English, they cannot directly jump into the sentences, paragraphs, you know, all of that, right? First, they have to learn the alphabets. Then they have to learn the words, then sentences, then paragraphs and all of that. Even if it is math, somebody should start it from the numbers. Then they have to move on to the other level, right? So in a similar way, what I'm trying to explain here is, if someone really wants to get into AI, the very, you know, the basic foundation is in terms of, like, you know, statistics and also a little bit of mathematics. Statistics, it's not that, like, you know, stats or math, by now you should know that. No, once you are started learning it, actually, you have to excel it, actually. It's not the complete amount of stats or mathematics. There are certain parts of stats or, like, you know, there are certain parts of math which you have to know. That is one thing. And the next thing is, like, you know, understanding a programming language is very, very important. Python will do. I'm going to say at the moment, Python is the most trending one. Then after that, you have to learn something called as exploratory data analysis, EDA, and you have to learn something called as data visualization. Then you have to learn supervised and unsupervised learning, which is ML. Then you have to move on to deep learning. Then you have to move on to NLP, which I was explaining about. And again, you have computer vision and other tools like, you know, Tableau and all of that stuff. So this is how you have to learn, guys. So in a nutshell, I'm trying to say somebody should learn stats, a bit of math, Python, machine learning, deep learning, NLP, SQL, and Tableau. So these are the requirements that you have. So by keeping all these things in mind, and also just by looking at the trend in the industry at the moment, at DataFolks, we have designed certain courses. So we thought, like, you know, those might be helpful for some working professionals or, like, you know, the students or, like, you know, the freshers and all of that. So we have designed courses that we have here. Guys, can I just give you a glimpse of the courses that we are offering at Power BI or Tableau? Anything will do, Atul. So people are preferring, you know, some people prefer Tableau, some people prefer Power BI. If you know one of them, then that's well and good. So guys, basically we have, like, you know, 4 courses. One is a student's pack, which almost goes for 2 months. We have another course, which is into data analytics. We have another course, which is into data sciences. And finally, we have a whole mix of, like, you know, all these things. Guys, I mean to say, student's pack is a part of remaining 3 things. Data analysis is a part of remaining 2 things. If I say artificial intelligence, that includes all these things. So let me just explain you that in terms of the semesters. So everywhere, the first semester goes into the stats foundation, and the second semester is into the basics of Python. Third one is into, like, you know, AI in Python. Then you will have something called as a capstone project. Whatever you have learned, you should be in a position to, like, you know, explain all of that, right? I mean to say, you should be in a position to, you know, apply that and, like, you know, do your own things. So that's where the capstones would help you. These 3 semesters, you know, are part of students' pack. Then you'll move on to something called as data analysis. The 4th semester is into data management, and the 5th is into data handling, and the 6th is into EDA for data science. Then you will get your 2nd capstone project, and you have to learn 1 elective, which is SQL for data science. Then this completes the data analysis course. By then, it will be almost, like, you know, 3 and a half months. Then you will move on to the 7th term, wherein you will have advanced statistics in machine learning. Then you have term 8, term 9, and term 10, were divided into machine learning into 3 parts. Then you also have something called as ML for AI, machine learning for AI. Then in term, you know, if you see after term 9, you have 1 capstone project, another capstone project. So this is how it is, guys. I mean to say, data science course contains almost, like, you know, 12 terms. When it comes to artificial intelligence, it is a mix of all these things, which contains almost 15 terms with 6 capstone projects. And by the time you finish your artificial intelligence, it would be almost 6 months. I mean to say it takes almost 6 months to finish the course. Now, this might be a little more confusing, but don't worry. I'm here to explain you guys certain things. Guys, the next thing is there are certain requirements if somebody has to enroll for this course. You all need to have a system with 4GB RAM. Then the next thing is you will have to spend 3 hours on Saturday, 3 hours on Sunday. So the next batch, which we are starting this weekend, that is in the time slot of 7 to 10, right? And the next one that we have is you will get the access to our teaching assistants. Then you will have the access to our DataFox community, wherein all the students, all the participants who have enrolled so far will be a part of it. Then you will have the access to DataFox Career Center. And finally, we will schedule your interview. So guys, if it is not still clear, we try to simplify it this way, okay? See, we have four courses, AI with Python. The first course will take 2 months with one capstone project and three terms. Second course contains two capstone projects, 6 terms and 3 months. And the third one is 4 capstone projects, takes 4 months and 11 terms. And the last one contains 15 terms, 6 months of time, and it will contain 3+3 capstone projects, right? These are the courses. Now, you might be wondering what is the investment that you have to do? Don't worry, I'm going to show that. So guys, the very first course that you have here costs anywhere about 50,000. Second one about 1 lakh, the third one about 3 lakhs, and the fourth one about 4 lakhs. But you should not really worry about the money, because we have created something called as DataFox Catapult Fund for those people who cannot really afford this amount of fees. So what we are trying to do here is, through this Catapult Fund that we have created, we are offering 90% of the scholarships at the moment. It is not discount, but it is a kind of scholarship, right? So after 90% of the scholarship, actually the first course, don't you think it is affordable now? It's just for 5,000 rupees plus GST. And the second one is just for 10,000 plus GST. And the third one for 30,000 plus GST, and the fourth one for 40,000 plus GST. So this is the kind of investment that one has to make. But one concern here is, guys, if you really wanted to avail the scholarship, you guys have to fill up a form. I mean to say, there is an inquiry form wherein we just try to get your contact details. So what happens is, once you guys fill the form, in tomorrow, so, first half itself, one of the counselors from our team will get in touch with you, and they will explain you whether you guys are eligible for the scholarship or not. Now, Deepanshi, may I request you to please float the form in the chat window? Guys, all of you, can you please take a moment to fill the form? Guys, it's just that our counselors will get in touch with you. They will understand your profile and they will suggest you something accordingly, right? I request everyone to please make use of this opportunity. And see, guys, next batch, we are starting this Saturday, that is on 17th July. What you have to do is, for any of the courses, you just have to pay 999 rupees plus the 18% of GST on it. So it comes almost close to 1180 rupees or something. First you fill the form, then you will get a call from our career consultant, then you can block your seat. Then you will get the access to the initial toolkit that we have, right? Go kit kind of thing. Guys, what are you waiting for? I request everyone to please fill the form. Now, the next thing is, guys, let me talk a little bit about our training methodology also. First 1 or 2 weeks, we will mentor you and we will take the feedback and we will monitor you. Then after that, we will help you to build the brand. Building the brand in the sense, for anybody who is into IT industry, having a LinkedIn profile, GitHub, and all of that is very, very important. So we will help you with that. Then after that, by the time you finish your 40% of the course, we will track your assignment and everything. Then here, when you reach almost 60% of your course, we will encourage you guys to be very active on these professional social media platforms such as LinkedIn, GitHub, and all these things. We will encourage you to write the articles and all of that stuff. Then, guys, how much ever you learn, finally, what is important is how you present yourself in the interview. So there we conduct the mock interviews. And if you guys are not up to the mark, we'll give you the feedbacks. Then accordingly, you guys have to correct and you have to appear for the final mark. And if you clear the final mark, then you'll be sent for the interviews. So this is a 100% placement, assistance program that we have. And she is Ritu Chavda, who will help you in the placements. She has got 12 plus years of experience. Along with her, we have Mr. Srimant Akesh, who is working as a data scientist in one of the MNCs, and he will help you in terms of like, you know, developing your resume, and he will help you in like, you know, making you guys prepare for the interviews and all of that stuff. So guys, once you are done with this thing actually, then you will get a certification which is globally valid. So that's it, guys. So if you're interested, then fill the form. Deepanshi, I request you to float the form one more time. Guys, I hope you all have enjoyed the session. You can also ask me any questions if you have. You can also find us on our DataFolks YouTube channel. All these recordings will be shared over there. We are also there on Instagram. We have two Instagram handles. So if you really want to see the updates, I request you all to follow our channels so that you will be updated. Okay. Sure. Guys, if you have, why use deep learning? ML is already there. Okay, deep learning is certain images related things and sequential data and all of that. When the data is very huge kind of thing, and if you wanted to capture each and every minute pattern in that, there deep learning is very important. Shashi, both of them have got. I have to repeat the slide of HR. One second, I'll do that. That's Ritu Chavda. I'm doing it. Okay, guys, any questions? She worked with Ematicus and other institutions also. Data science is a part of AI. It's all based on your interest, actually. First, you can fill the form, Shubham. Then our counselors will suggest you as per your profile. Shall be happy okay, he's aspirant of NEET. That's perfect. You can just fill the form, Nitin. I mean, our counselor will suggest you the best. For more information, all this, Priyanka, this video will be uploaded. I don't think, the presentation can be shared. So there are certain restrictions from our end also. I don't think the presentation can be shared, right? So guys, how was the webinar guys? Definitely, if somebody is interested, I request them to fill the form, please. Sure. I hope you all had a good time in the webinar. Tibach, Disauza, that's perfect. So I'll see you on this Saturday then. Tribert, right? Of course, Nitin, that can be done. Majority of the marketing firms use that. You can understand the trends from that, definitely. Sure. Fantastic, Atul. Then you can meet me on the set. Guys, if you really wanted to have some experienced mentors, right? Then definitely I request you all to join the course. Not just me, there are many other experienced trainers. Not possible now, Tribert. I mean to say, once you get into the course, actually, then you will also have the sessions with Ms. Ritu Chavda. She'll be taking some of your sessions also. Don't worry. Everything goes in some order. Okay. I cannot really share anybody's details over here. So, guys, that's it for the day. And I hope you all had a great time in the session. Thank you. That's fine, Tribert. You can write to academics team. They'll help you with that. You can get in touch with her. I don't have those details. Sorry, I cannot really disclose. Sure. Okay, guys. I'll see you on this Saturday. Those people who have enrolled for the course. And a good night and stay safe, guys. I hope you all are vaccinated. Right? Sure. Thank you, all of you. Good night. Please fill the form.